Costco recently announced that starting next week, they will be raising their minimum wage for employees to $16 an hour. Costco said that they believe that paying their employees good wages makes sense for their business and actually makes for a more productive employee. Their decision comes at a time when many members of Congress are fighting to federally mandate the minimum wage to $15, a campaign promise made by President Biden. The current federal minimum wage has been 7.25 since 2009, and according to CNN, 61% of registered voter supporters support to raise to 15. Ladies, I'm curious about your thoughts on Costco's decision to fight for $15.
I've always loved Costco. Good people of Costco. They make great croissants and cakes. This is necessary. I feel that, like, this is necessary. This is the direction that we need to move in. And I love the statement that they made about making more productive workers. Yes, give people incentive to work. I can't begin to imagine the frustration of having to go to a job every day and you still can't provide for your family. Yes, that's going to be discouraging. That does not make me be like, yay, let me get in there and kill it for you while Costco continues to become a multi-million dollar franchise and a company and be these. And yet here I am putting in the labor and I can't even feed my family. So I applaud Costco. I hope that more people start to see this and do the same.
Absolutely. And it's insane to me to think that when I, back way back when I was working at TGI Fridays, I was making minimum wage, which was just maybe $1.70 different from this. And that's over 15 years ago, $1.70. And today, with the cost of inflation, my God, my parents' house has tripled, specifically, in how much it costs to buy a home today. So how are people supposed to make it when you give them $5 and a $5 bill and $2 additional to then build a salary to be able to afford the cost of homes or school or clothing, things that continue to rise?
You're setting them up for failure.
It's crazy. And the second thing I think that really drastically needs to change besides the minimum wage is the salary for teachers, our educators.
Oh, yes.
They're still making below the amount that it costs to afford their own children, their own families' incomes, and their own food and clothing. It's insane to me that the educators make
really
the worst in our economy.
Really
so
is.
Yes, yeah. Beyond, yes, let's do this already. And set the standard, thank you, Costco, setting the standard for these other huge companies like Walmart, McDonald's, like if you can, you're making, when you're not paying your employees, it's just going into the pocket to the person at the top. Start taking care of our communities.
Yep.
That's right.
I agree.
That is right.
Well, it's Tyrese time again because, you know, he's the gift that keeps giving on the gram. When it comes to girl chat, thank you, Tyrese, for giving me my topics. Following his split from his wife, Samantha, Tyrese has found himself back on the single scene and is finding it a lot harder than he remembered. Tyrese posted to Instagram and said in part, "This single life hits different, especially since I could have never, ever seen this coming, ever. Back to the basics. What's your name? Where you from? Who your mama am? Nim. What you do? What's your credit score? Jesus or nah?" Ladies, what advice do you give our good brother Tyrese on getting back into the dating game after a long relationship? Let's help TT. Let's help TT.
That was real, though. He nailed the basics. He nailed the essentials.
He really did. Tyrese said that he can't wait to meet the new him. And I recommend that he probably wait to meet the new him before he meets a new her. I just think
that part.
Work on yourself. Relationships are tough. It's really, and I get getting back, you know, being single again after he's been married. So I say, Tyrese, take your time. Get to know you. You don't need to worry about who's mama and them right now. Just worry about you.
Garcelle, since you and I came out of, well, actually, I don't know. How long was your marriage and then when you divorced and went back into the dating
scene? Almost 9 years.
They say.
Almost 9 years
okay, so
married.
Same 10 years for me. So as much as he's being funny, did you have a moment of like, you know, kind of like you feel like you're at the beach where you see these huge waves coming at you and you're afraid to put one toe in. You're like, what am I getting into? Do I want to go back out there?
Absolutely.
I do remember that feeling. You almost dread it, right? You get out of marriage and you're like, oh my God, I just wish you could just find nice people to just have a moment with, whether it's a coffee or a dinner. Yeah. But the dating part, the getting to know part is so weird. It is a thing.
It's so weird. And also at my age, when I got divorced, I was in my late 40s. And it's like, that's not when you want to start all over and start finding out who their name is and who their mama and them is. That's not when you want to know. You want to... I didn't expect to be here. So it's daunting. I get it. And he's famous and, you know, he loves to share. So I would just like for him to take his time.
Yeah. And I would double down on Garcelle's advice for anybody who does get out, who is getting out of a long-term relationship. Please do not feel like you got to rush back into that scene.
Exactly.
Because that already will make you awkward, and it'll actually come out in the way you start to choose people, because you'll start to function more on, I got to be dating with somebody.
Desperation.
Rather than just, who am I now who's blessed enough to go and meet my acquaintance? So take your time and don't feel like you got to rush into it. Seriously.
Definitely. Okay, Tyrese, we then gave you our thoughts.